promoting what differences?
Yeah, well, I mean, for me, that is the question, and it comes back to this, to why I'm working on Trustlines, right? So the thing about blockchain and making payments accessible, it's not just about making the technology accessible, it's about making money itself accessible. And with most top-down money systems, you have to acquire the money in the first place. You know, imagine if Bitcoin took off, you still have to buy Bitcoin. Like, the average person still has to buy Bitcoin from the miners or from the community. And if you don't have any money, if you don't have wealth, then that's, you know, how are you going to get around that? So a real effective medium of exchange should not be limited by arbitrary restrictions, which happens when money is created top down. So with a system of mutual credit, that situation is reversed. And individuals, or the money users basically, will be issuing money according to when they need it. So it's a much more accessible form of money, regardless of the technology that it lives on. I would also add that cryptocurrencies have huge barriers to joining at the moment. You know, the idea, the original idea was that anyone can join. You know, anyone can interact with a permissionless blockchain. Anyone can handle currency with an anonymous or pseudonymous address. But the reality is that if you want to buy a cryptocurrency, you have to register on an exchange. You have to have a bank account, because, as said before, you have to buy cryptocurrency with your presumably fiat money. You know, and all of these are inaccessible to a lot of people. If you have a different type of monetary logic, then if you combine that with the technological innovation of having a peer-to-peer infrastructure, then that can make a money system truly accessible to even someone who all they have is a phone.
Thank you.